Recently, Adobe updated Lightroom Classic to version 11.4 and Lightroom Desktop to version 5.4, as well as Lightroom on mobile. I will demonstrate these new features as well as tell you where the overlap is. There are features that will work across all three. If you haven't yet subscribed, hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications and you won't miss any of my tutorials. So with this latest update, one of the things you have now is the ability to make adjustments to video clip on your phone. Here I'm in Lightroom Mobile. I press on this gear right here. It's for video quality. Clicking up here on the crop icon at the top. With that, I can trim my video, my front and back of the video. Now editing here will not let you piece clips together. You could just trim the front and the end of the clip, but you have all these adjustments here. You have all these presets that you can use with the video. This will apply a preset to the whole clip, and you can make adjustments to exposure, contrast, highlights, like you would editing normally in Lightroom. And of course, you can export your clip and share it. You can also import your video into Lightroom Classic. Here we are in the library mode. Video is not supported in the development mode in Lightroom Classic. Of course, you can play your video here. If you click on this gear, here's where you can trim the ends of your video clip. And since we're in the library module here, here's the only place that you can actually make changes to your exposure, your contrast, whites, blacks, vibrance. And you can use some presets. You can select those to see which ones will apply here. And you can also make adjustments to your video clip in Lightroom Desktop. Up here in the top right, here's your crop. I can trim the front and the back of the video. But Lightroom Desktop is best for editing because you have all of these controls like you do in Lightroom Basic. Plus you have your color grading and effects. So you have a lot more control. Presets, you can try here too. You can hover over any of these presets. Right now I'm on style, cinematic, and you can see that I am hovering over the presets and trying to see which one looks good. So when you apply these presets, it applies to the whole clip. And now that you can make adjustments to your clip, it's good, especially if you do it on your phone. This is really good to make some quick adjustments to your clips that you might want to put on Instagram Reels or TikTok. You can make some quick adjustments to the color. So now let's go over to where we have some new features with presets. You have a lot of new presets here. And new to the presets is this amount slider up here. So right now I'm in subject urban architecture and I'm highlighting each of these and you can see that my image is changing. If I choose one of these, you see the amount slider is highlighted. And that's one of the things with presets. Sometimes all the presets together are too much, too strong. And now this is like a opacity slider in a way, but it is actually just decreasing some of the values over here in the basic panel proportionally to the amount slider. So if I take the amount all the way down and look over in the basic panel, you can see the controls jump to different levels. If I take the amount all the way up, you see the controls will adjust proportionally. And if you choose another preset, you see that the values are changing over there in the basic panel. And you'll be able to use these presets and the same amount slider in Lightroom Desktop. I'll go down to that same effect and I can change my amount slider here in Lightroom Desktop. And I can change any of my presets here the same way in Lightroom Desktop. So now under presets, we have something called adaptive, in this case, sky. So when I hover over any of these presets, you see that Lightroom is generating my preset, and this is actually at sunset. So I'm going to select the sunset, and at the top, you see I have my amount slider, increase it or decrease it. But what's different about these presets is if you go over here to the masking icon, you see that a new mask has been created called the sunset. So that's what adaptive means. It, once you select your preset, it will create a mask for that area, in this case, the sky. So that's adaptive sky. And also in Lightroom Desktop, I have the same presets. I can come down here to adaptive sky, click sunset, change my amount, click on my masking icon, and there's the mask that it created the same way it did in Lightroom Classic. And under presets, you have adaptive subject. So this will select your subject. As you hover over each of these presets, it is adding the preset just over the subject. So if I choose vibrant and I come over here to my masking icon, Again, I have a vibrant preset mask just around the subject. Same thing over here in Lightroom Desktop. I got my presets. I got my adaptive subject. Click on vibrant. I can change my amount. And here's my mask. So that is adaptive subject. So now we want to talk about masking, specifically inverting several masks. So I'm going to come over here to the mask icon. And the first thing I want to do is select the sky. My sky is selected. And now I'm going to select the subject. A little bit of this tree was selected, so I'm going to hit subtract. I'm going to take the brush, and I'm just going to paint over this area right here so it doesn't select part of my tree. I have all these masks here. Mask 1, brush, subject, and sky. Now say I want to make changes to everything else but the sky and the boat. So that's the sand and the water. So I want to brighten up the palm tree and the sand area. If I come up to these three dots and say invert mask 1, now all the other masks are inverted. And what is selected is the tree, the sand, and the water. All the masks were inverted at the same time. And I can increase the exposure a little bit, brighten up the sand area, change the highlights a little bit. So now all the masks were taken care of at the same time when I inverted mask 1. There's the before and there's the after. So that's inverting all the masks. And you can do the same thing in Lightroom Desktop. In another new feature, if you click on crop and hit O, you cycle through your crop overlays. And there is a new one in here, fifths. So new crop overlay. Now let's continue with masking. I have this first image selected here. I'm going to go to my mask icon and I'm going to say select sky. Oh, I'm going to make this sky stand out a little bit, make a couple adjustments here. And now say I want to work with the foreground. Now I'm going to click on mask 1. I'm going to click on these three dots right here. And it says duplicate and invert mask. So now the foreground is selected. I can work on that. Bring up the shadows a little bit and just make some minor adjustments. So there, using the duplicate and inverse mask. And we're able to do this also in Lightroom Desktop. So now we're going to see another feature called batch masking. So I'm going to use the same example, the same image. And what I'm going to do down here in my film strip is right click. And where it says develop settings, copy settings. And up here, I'm going to click on masking. So it's going to copy all the masking. I'm going to say copy. I'm going to select three more similar images and another one that is totally different. So I'm selecting four more images. I'm going to right click, go to where it says develop settings and say paste settings. And now it's working on all those masks. The AI is updating the masks. So here's the first image, another image, similar sky, similar angle. All images have used AI to determine the sky in the foreground. And the same with this last image. It determined where the sky was, changes to the same settings I had before. So now the mask settings has been copied to all the other images and the sky looks the same. And you can do the same thing in Lightroom Desktop. Another way that you can utilize duplicate and invert mask and also batch masking is select four images that are similar. Then I'm going to come over here to where the sync button is and click here and it's on auto sync. Then I'm going to hit the mask icon and say select sky. I'm going to make my sky adjustments. It's updating four images at once. And I'm going to click on the three dots and say duplicate and invert mask. So it's doing that for all four images. I can bring my shadows up and make any other adjustments I want. And I'm going to turn off auto sync. And here are my four images that I adjusted. Skies look pretty much the same. So that method updated all four images at the same time, both in masking and adjustments. So this feature, it is new to Lightroom Desktop that was already in Lightroom Classic. It's the compare mode. So I come up here to view, compare, and here I can hit the swap, swaps the images. I can change the orientation of how these are displayed, vertical view or images right on top of each other. But this is new to Lightroom Desktop. So now another feature, it's red eye correct. It's in both Lightroom Classic and Lightroom Desktop, but it works slightly different in Lightroom Desktop. If you come up here to this, the healing icon, click on that. And up here, here is red eye. Click on that. And here in Lightroom Desktop, there is an autocorrect. So I click on that. Let's see how it does. And it found four eyes and corrected them all at the same time. This is great for group shots. If I bring my cursor down across all the eyes, you can see where Lightroom has identified the eye. You could change the pupil size and darken. If I want to do red eye correction in Lightroom Classic, there is a red eye icon right here. I click on that. You notice it does not have an autocorrect like Lightroom Desktop does. But if I click on red eye and I bring my cursor over somebody's pupil and click, in this case, I'm going to each eye and clicking, and you can go to each eye and adjust this and move the correction around if you need to, and also darken the pupils over here. So that is red eye correction in Lightroom Classic and Lightroom Desktop. If you want more tutorials just like this, click on one of the videos on the screen now. If you haven't already, like, share, and subscribe. And remember, it's never too late to learn. Thanks for watching.